Hey everyone, welcome to the world of skull carving. So today I'm actually working on something, not a skull, but I've got a snapping turtle which I've had in storage for about 15 years. I brought it out, cleaned it up, turned out really nice, and so I've been thinking of like what exactly I wanted to do with this, and came up with a really cool idea, I think, if I can actually get this to work out. I'm going to do a maze. Yeah, and this is pretty complicated. I was thinking of something simple, but I think I'm going to go for it. The trick here is transferring the maze to the skull, to the shell. Obviously, the shell has a lot of these ridges, and it's not flat whatsoever. But I think we can work around it. I've cut some slots into the paper to help with that. I'm going to move along here, see what I can do, and we'll go from there. So I'm going to put on my pattern here, my gloss gel, to transfer the pattern. And this is the top of the maze, so the top's going to go here. And work towards the middle.
In April of 1775, this great nation started coming alive. Old King George didn't like it one bit, so he proceeded to throw him a royal fit.
Okay, so got my pattern on there. As best as I want it. I'm not going to try to rub it off anymore, just because I can work with the lines I've got here, so I'm not going to risk rubbing any of that off. So we're ready to start. I'm going to let it dry off a little bit, and then we're going to start carving. So what I'm going to use to carve on the turtle shell here is this little disc attachment on the Dremel. Of course, remember to wear ear protection and eye protection. And I'm just going to barely scrape the surface of it with this with the disc tool. You'll see how I do it. Just enough to make a little bit of a groove, and then once it's all carved up, we'll come back, we'll put a stain on it, so that'll really bring out the pattern of the maze that we got going on here. Alright, let's get started.
Generals better, get them back in line, make them pay my taxes, now America is mine. Stop that independence talk before it gets around, or it's gonna be hard.
Okay, so I took this out, put in my number 105 grinding bit. It's just the design is a little bit too detailed for this, and this is just a bit too big for it. And I also printed out the design as well, so I can kind of keep track of where I'm at.
Down. Well, the king was talking about the men like Paul Revere and the Minutemen who held their dream of independence dear. They kept their eyes on the British, they watched them day and night. They knew very soon they'd get their chance to stand and fight. Yes, they knew that the British would be moving any hour, so they arranged a signal in the North End Church Tower. Paul was watching when the tower showed a light, and he started on his midnight ride. He jumped on his horse, blues started humming. He screamed out his warning, redcoats are coming. Better get your guns and your fighting britches on. They're coming and they're 800 strong. Next morning at Concord and Lexington town, the spirit of freedom turned the redcoats around. When we praise the men who made this mighty nation we have here, then let's remember Paul Revere. Yes, let's remember Paul Revere.
Well, there you have it. I finished it all up. Now I'm going to soak it in some water and get the outside of the pattern off, and then we'll move on to the staining. Okay, so I've been thinking about what's the best way to stain the snapping turtle shell to make the design come out the best way possible. And I came up with an idea which I think is going to turn out really well. I'm actually just going to use a Sharpie to trace inside the lines that I've carved. And then you can see, obviously, it brings the carving out really well. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the whole thing, and then we're going to just kind of rub a stain on the whole thing, and we'll see how that comes out. Okay, here it is. Turned out pretty darn good. What I'm going to do next is rub on with just some paper towel some water-based paint, and that's key. I'm going to dilute it down in some water, then use a brush to just brush it on, and then I'll wipe it off. Don't have anything to hold my camera, so next thing you'll see is it done. Okay, so we are done. Pretty happy with the way it turned out. Pretty much what I imagined. You can see, so I kind of stained the outside a little bit, just made it a little bit darker, in addition to the black inside the carving lines there. What I'm going to do is make a frame with a glass front and back, so that you will be able to see the structure of the snapping turtle in addition to the carving on the front. I'm going to make that, and I'll post that on Facebook pictures later on, so be sure to check that out. It was quite the process to do this. I probably put about 12 to 14 hours total into this, but well worth it. I really liked it, enjoyed it. So, if you all could subscribe and like the video, that lets me know that I'm serving you all, and it lets YouTube know that people are actually watching my stuff, which I appreciate, and I'll be sure to post some more stuff up soon. Again, hit subscribe and like. If you have any comments, please leave them. I do respond, and let me know what you think.